Drill Group Band. From making music without police permission. From L. Hunt, June 15th, 2018. The court order is an unprecedented legal first. A London drill group has been issued with a court order which bans them from making music without the police's permission. The restrictions are a legal first in the United Kingdom. Five members of the West London 1011 must now seek permission from Scotland Yard before recording or performing music following an unprecedented ruling at Kingston Crown Court. They're also banned from writing lyrics which, quote, encourage stringent criminal behavior orders, known as CBOs, have now been imposed on the group for the next 3 years, as well as the ban on encouraging violence. 1011 are also forbidden from making reference to their own gang or rival gangs in their music or on social media, as well as referencing post codes in a gang context, reports, or TV. The unprecedented restrictions also say that 1011 must not possess balaclavas or attend Notting Hill Carnival. So we could go on, but let's talk about this for just a little bit. Now, I have not heard this drill group, and I'm not even really sure what kind of music drill is, though if it's gang related, they're wearing balaclavas, they're probably trying to sound really masculine or macho or tough, right? So the question is, what does this mean? What does it mean when the police can tell you you're not allowed to make reference to things in your music? You're not allowed to perform music, not allowed to write lyrics that the court does not approve of. The United Kingdom has been going down this path for a long, long time. Being able to choose what musicians say is not completely out of what is imaginable. Is still remarkable that this can be what the court system chooses to direct its energy and effort to. This certainly will not be the last time that such powers are used to control what is written, to control what is encouraged, to control what is said. When young people cannot say what they feel, when people, even angry, cannot write poetry, which is really all lyrics are, it's just poems set to music. When poetry and music can't express what people desire in a way that isn't actually acting out, when groups are suffering enough, when they feel their lives aren't fair, when they feel that they have no power, no agency, sometimes music will make their lives feel just that little bit more under control. Little bit more meaningful. And here the court is taking away that last little bit of meaning from their lives. That's a terrible thing. People try to speak up, and the one person group that is speaking up, that is saying what probably a lot of people in their community are thinking, and they are silenced. Not stop there. They'll silence other groups. They'll keep other lyrics from being written. Maybe the next greatest poet. The United Kingdom has a long history of poets, all the way to Lord Byron, who were sometimes violent, sometimes encouraged violence, but always said what people felt to be true to them. Tradition of words that go through the medium through which they're written and read and believed and held dear. These poems, these lyrics, even lyrics that frighten. Being unable to write them, unable to say them. Leads very closely to being unable to think down certain paths. Unable to imagine certain ways, certain alternatives. And this case, who knows? Maybe they were very angry. Maybe they inspired others to do harm. What is being restricted here? It's not just gangs. It's not just this one band. Because what keeps the next band from writing the same lyrics? What keeps them from telling, from sneaking for others to claim as their own? If they are passionate enough to write music, they are passionate enough to avoid detection. Poets and those who write lyrics have a knack for language, for the use of language. Courts cannot let a ruling like this not be obeyed. It sets up a situation of enforcement, of putting the tools of restricting lyrics tools of restricting thoughts in the hands of an enforcement agency of the police in the United Kingdom, who will not hesitate to use it on you. Music and lyrics, poetry, thoughts, how they are communicated in the 21st century is through the internet. Once the court system starts restricting what people can write, say, think, they will be forced with an unmovable boundary of the internet. The words will find their way there. The words in the hands of the poets will be hidden and squirreled onto cell phones. Find their way online, and we will read them. We will read them, we will see them, and we will understand and consider them. And if they are willing to prevent them from being written, they will be willing to come for the internet itself. The European Union is currently coming for the internet with the EU Copyright Directive, Article 13. This is not the first, and it will not be the last attempt to restrict what people can and cannot say. And in the UK, there are internet filters. restricting the use of the internet to share poetry and lyrics already waiting to be used in cases like this. If you are watching this video, this is how it starts. The suppression of thoughts, of lyrics, of poetry, of things that you would not normally read. You would not normally listen to groups that cannot afford legal representation on the order of a large corporation. A win here